Hey, my name's Rusty, and I'm here to talk about the primary assessment and the ABCs. We're going to start off by listening to the Jackson 5 sing some ABCs. And they are right. The ABCs are as easy as 1, 2, 3. The steps to a primary assessment are general impression, level of consciousness, threats to life, airway, breathing, circulation, disability, expose, and set your priority of transport. We're going to talk about each of these individually. First, we're going to start off with the general impression. The American Academy of Pediatrics developed the Pediatric Assessment Triangle, but I've modified it a little bit. This general impression is done from across the room to determine if your patient is sick or not sick. The three legs of the Pediatric Assessment Triangle is appearance, work of breathing, and circulation. Look for another video, and I'll tell you what all those acronyms mean. But for right now, the Pediatric Assessment Triangle, appearance, work of breathing, and circulation is used for our general impression. Next, we're going to determine the level of consciousness. Hey, hey, are you okay? Start off with that AVPU scale. Are they alert, responsive to verbal stimuli, responsive to painful stimuli, or are they unresponsive? If they don't respond to verbal, get those knuckles out. Give them a little sternal rub to see if they respond to pain. They don't respond to pain, they are unresponsive. However, if our patients are alert, then we're going to determine if they are alert and oriented times 4, person, place, time, and event, by asking the questions out from each of those categories. Next is threats to life, threats to airway, breathing, and circulation. If our airway is blocked, that's a big threat. The tongue is the biggest violator. So position that airway correctly. Then threats to breathing is disruptions in ventilations, sucking chest wounds and things like that need to be taken care of now. And then exsanguinating hemorrhage that just can't be ignored. They're bleeding all over the place. You need to slap the tourniquet on quickly. So threats to life. Next, airway. It's that hopefully clear pipe from outside to in, and we're first going to position it and suction as needed. Then we're going to look for rise and fall of the chest, listen for air exchange, feel for the breath on our cheek and a carotid pulse. I've added this step, smell. Let's smell for alcohol or ketones for our DKA patients, and then we're going to secure this airway with a simple airway adjunct. So open, look, listen, feel, smell, and secure for the airway step. Then it's breathing. Notice patterns and speed. Supplement with oxygen as needed, but don't take time right now to count the rate. We'll get that later in vital signs. Circulation. Look and feel. Look for skin color and texture. Feel for that skin temperature and texture, and also feel for that carotid pulse. Noticing rate, but don't count their pulse rate yet. We'll do it in vital signs. Next is disability. This step is used to evaluate cerebral function, but we've already taken care of level of consciousness. So let's look at D's. And D's means your pupils. Get that pin light out and make sure their pupils are equal, round, react to light, and accommodate. So, and then you can start calculating that GCS scale for disability. Next is expose at least the chest so we can get a good listen to lung sounds and to place leads later when we hook them up to the ECG. So expose what you need to and do it at this step. Last, set the priority of transport. Are they a load and go? You need to sweep them off to a hospital right away? Or are they a stay and play and we can do a secondary assessment? So determine that priority of transport. I'm sure some of you are asking yourself, why in the world did we listen to the Jackson 5 at the beginning? It's to set that tempo of a memory jogger to help you with the steps of the primary assessment or the primary survey. And here it goes. The GLT, it's easy as ABC. Then you look at these, expose these to set your priority to end your primary survey. I know I'm not much of a singer, but it's a catchy little beat that could help you remember the steps. The GLT, it's easy as ABC. Then you look at these, expose these to set your priority to end that primary survey. General impression, level of consciousness, threats to life, airway, breathing, circulation, disability, expose what you need to, set the priority of transport. That GLT, it's easy as ABC. Then you look at these, expose these to set the priority to end that primary survey. Special thanks to YouTube and the Jackson 5, the American Academy of Pediatrics, National Registry of EMTs, and folks that I stole some pictures from to create this. I hope you enjoyed it, and just remembered, the ABCs are as easy as 1, 2, 3. Have a good day.